guys, this is Paul with rcFoamFighters. Welcome back for this week's video. This week we're going to have kind of a short part two on the KF Condor. And after that, I'm going to get into a couple other small projects that I've been working on the side also. So let's get into the KF Condor project and see how it all goes. Okay guys, got the KF Condor pretty much cut out, all the basic pieces. Now I'm getting ready to do a glide test. We've actually done a couple, and I'm just adding random weights to get the center of gravity about where we want it, and then we just do gentle tosses to see how it glides. Once you get it gliding fairly good, that's when you know your CG is pretty good, and that helps you get everything dialed in before you even throw it into the air the first time when you have it finished. So.
Okay, here's the glide test.
That worked really good.
That was perfect, man.
Okay guys, we're back inside the workshop in the basement. We finished up our glide tests and I found the CG to be roughly about 15 inches back from the nose. I've been doing some testing of placing the parts on the plane, like the motor, the ESC, and the batteries, trying to see how the plane would balance out with different types of motors and parts on there. Kind of running into a little bit of a dilemma though. It seems like the CG is actually pretty far forward on this plane if you look at it. It's more than halfway forward on the plane, so it's going to make it really hard to balance this plane if I put the motor in the back. And I've been trying out a bunch of different combos with this motor and these several motors back here, and also different battery sizes, anywhere from a 22 to 2600. And it's been really hard to find the right combination that would balance out with the motor on the rear. So I'm thinking I'm just going to change the design up a little bit. And I think I'm going to mount the motor on the front of the plane. This is actually going to be a front prop plane. And actually the first front prop scratch build plane I've built. So I'm going to modify the nose to incorporate the motor up front. And I think it'll balance a lot easier that way since the center of gravity on this plane is so far forward. I could probably also do a mid-mount motor. But it seems like it'd break up the fuselage lines and I didn't really like the way that would look. So I think I'm just going to go forward with the forward mounted motor and see how it all works out. Okay, I finished making the motor mount. I actually put a big stick on the back so it'll be a little bit more secure when it's glued into the foam. And I took the welder hot knife and I carved out a nice long channel for the stick to fit in. And I'm going to put some epoxy to glue this in, and basically just slides right into the front of the plane like that. This V shape is, I had to carve it out to allow for the wires to fit into the plane on the motor. So basically the motor is going to fit on the front like that. Okay guys, well here's basically where I'm at with the KF Condor now. I've got the motor securely mounted up to the front of the plane and the wires are coming out the side. I'm going to be mounting the ESC probably to the side here. I'm going to embed it in the side of the plane. And a little farther back, I've cut the battery bay into the fuselage here. Basically it'll be under this cover. I'll be able to mount the batteries under here. And as you can see, I've got the KF airfoils ready all glued on top of the main wing, so those are all ready to go. Last I'll be adding the elevons and also the vertical stabilizer and the little wings, as you remember, were on the paper airplane. They'll be mounted right up here, right in front of the vertical stabilizer. Those go on top. So it's coming along pretty good, I think. Hopefully in the next video I'll have it all completed and we'll get to go out and do the maiden flights. Okay, well that'll pretty much complete the KF Condor portion of the video this week. I'm pretty happy with the way it's going. It seems like it's coming together pretty good. I just have to put the rest of the electronics in and probably do some taping on it. And then we'll get out to the park to do the maiden flights on it. So please stay tuned because there'll be more of the KF Condor coming up in the coming weeks. Okay, up next I just wanted to throw out a couple short portions of the video covering some of the projects I've been working on also on the side at the same time that I'm doing the KF Condor. I guess that's kind of why I'm slow at finishing the KF Condor. But I've decided to make a FoamFighter 23, a smaller version of it after visiting my friend John in Herman. He actually made a smaller version of the FoamFighter 22, so I thought it might be a cool idea to see what we could do with the FoamFighter 23. So I decided to make it out of Depron, some Depron that I had lying around for quite a while actually that I haven't used. So I decided to scale the plane down from a 24-inch wingspan down to a 21-inch wingspan. Basically the same thing that we did with the FoamFighter 22 for John. Okay guys, here's just a quick glimpse of the FoamFighter 23 that I have completed here. Basically, it's built out of the gray, black Depron foam. It weighs in at roughly a little over 15 ounces. Right now, I've just got a small turnigy motor on there. I'm going to run until I get it dialed in. Then later on, I'll probably replace it with the 22126 motor from RC Hot Deals. And it'll probably fly a lot faster with that. But just for the testing phases, I'm going to use a smaller motor until I get everything dialed in and just see how it works with the KF airfoil that I added on top. And so let's get out to the park and see how this baby flies.
This is going to be the maiden flight. I'm not totally sure how it's going to fly. This one, there is a different airfoil on here. I put the KF2 on this plane. Hopefully help stabilize it in the roll. It's a little twitchy on the original model. So this is going to be the first one here. Let's see how it goes. Oh, yeah.
Is it a lot more stable, Paul, or what?
Right off the bat.
No rocking or anything like the old plane. Gotta love that KF2, man.
Yeah, it's proven to be very good for the KF airfoil. This plane's flying way more stable than the original one.
Yeah, the original one had roll issues.
Yeah, it's really, this one's solid. That's cool, first toss.
So it seems like it's dialed right in, man?
Yeah.
It's not nosing up or down or anything? Do a glide test.
Going up a little bit. That's the KF. And I actually moved the center of gravity forward from my original model. And it looks like the KF is still making it climb a little.
What'd that model weigh in at, Paul?
It was a little over 15 ounces, 15.2, I believe.
So looks like it flies awesome, man.
It's going to be a good little small park flyer. You know, something when you want to fly in smaller areas, not so fast. Yeah, it's definitely a lot more stable than the one without the KF airfoil. But like Frank, I think I'm becoming a true believer in using KF airfoils on these planes. So, big credit to Dick Klein.
What about loops and barrel rolls? How does it do?
Barrel roll.
Whoa, that thing spins pretty crazy.
Let me get it going a little higher and I'll do a loop.
Dang, man. That's like vector thrust already.
Yeah, it's got an elevator right behind the prop, so it catches the prop blast. So it makes it almost like vector thrust. Yeah, so anybody building a YF-23 or one of these Foam Fighter 23s, I'd recommend definitely putting the KF-2 on the plane. It makes it a lot more stable.
Okay, last I just want to throw out some more little video of the second project, or third project actually, that I'm working on. This project is based roughly on the silhouette of a picture of the Aurora aircraft that I found. The Aurora is a rumored aircraft that's out there that's supposedly the plane that took over from the SR-71. It's supposed to be a super fast plane. Nobody's really confirmed that it really exists. But I found a pretty cool artist impression of the plane. They had a pretty cool silhouette. So I kind of use that as the basis of the plane. And basically it's going to be built into being a speed plane. So I did a couple test flights of it out at the Herman Airport. I think I still have a lot of dialing in to do, but let me just throw a quick view of it out and you guys can take a look and let me know what you guys think. Okay guys, here's just a quick glimpse at the Aurora aircraft that I'm working on. Again, the Aurora aircraft is an aircraft that's just rumored right now. Nobody's really confirmed that it really exists. I basically just based the silhouette or the outline of the plane on an artist impression that I found on the internet, but the rest of it is just kind of all made up by me, the tail fins and the fuselage and all that stuff. Right now I've got a Grayson Hobbies Super Mega Jet on it. It seemed like it flew fairly quick with that motor, but I'm probably going to be changing the motor out with maybe something more powerful in the future. After I get it all dialed in, I'm probably going to put a bigger motor, bigger batteries, and a bigger ESC on there and see what we can push this thing to fly at. Hopefully I can break well into the 100 mile an hour speeds with this plane when it's all done and finished. Okay guys, that'll pretty much complete the video for this week for me. As you can see, I've been pretty busy working on three projects at the same time, so hopefully I'll get these three done. And I actually got a couple more lined up that I'm gonna be working on. I have a couple cool ideas that hopefully they'll work out and be some more cool aircraft for you guys to take a look at and maybe even build if you like. But anyway, if you haven't already done so, please take a look at our blog and take a look at our free drawing that we're having this month. Frank's going to be giving away a basic kit for his Skyfighter version 2 plan. He's going to cut out all the EPP and kind of shave it for you, and throw in the carbon rods and some of the other basic parts. So if you haven't entered the drawing yet, please take a look at our blog and look how to enter it. And good luck to everybody who has.